Construction of a COVID treatment center has been completed at Tambarara Regional Referral Hospital as the hospital and indeed the district grapples with a surge in cases of COVID-19. The facility has an intensive care unit that holds up to 42 beds and was built by support from the Government of Uganda and the Global Health Collaboration Initiative.
While officiating at the launch of the center, Mbarara City Resident Commissioner Lieutenant Colonel James Mwesigwa hailed the government and Global Health Collaborative for putting up the structure. He described it as a relief project that will expand the hospital's capacity to manage COVID cases and save more lives.
People would talk, you know, these people talk in Dora, and some of us are not used to Dora. People would talk in dollars, how many dollars? Where are these dollars going to come from? So I want to thank Global Health, our sisters and brothers, our development partners, for your good heart, for being very good to the people of all colors that we have labored. Scratch from your area and brought what we thought it cannot be done, and it's now done. Thank you so much.
The event was also attended by a team of health experts from Mass Acutes General Hospital, who are at Mbarara Hospital for 10 days to support efforts to treat COVID-19 patients. Dr. Celestine Barije, the Mbarara Hospital Director, said the center will help to decongest the existing units that are admitting COVID-19 patients at Mbarara Hospital.
However, now the furnishing takes actually more money. Global Health has come in to give us 170 million worth of beds, 42 beds, 4 ICU beds and other 42 ordinary beds, mattresses, 42, but also 4 monitors and other things. They have also sent us a team here of experts from American, from Mass General Hospital, who are helping in training and making sure how we are going to use this, because they already have experience.
Dr. Stephen Asimwe, the program manager of Global Health Collaborative, said the center will start admitting patients by the middle of the month. He said they also plan to establish an oxygen plant at the center.
Equipment and supplies to kickstart the opening of this facility.
The needle is put
right now. Right now, as you can see, the place is not yet fully ready to accept patients. The biggest treatment we need is oxygen. We are still in talks with some potential donors to see if we can get an oxygen plant fitted for this.
You clap for the promise.
On the same day, Epicenter also donated 10 ICU beds and 5 oxygen cylinders to Mbarara Referral Hospital. The donation was handed over to hospital's management by Juliet Mwanga, the Epicenter director.
So I discussed with my team in Paris, and I said, okay, for now to start with, since the most important needs are the ICU beds and oxygen, let us support with that. So today we are delivering the first consignment of 10 ICU beds. Wow. And oxygen cylinders, I think we have like 5 oxygen cylinders. So these things are very difficult to find in Uganda now, yeah. But my team worked so hard to find a few. So we have 10 and they're up there, which we shall be giving to you.
The commission new COVID center has expanded the hospital's ICU bed capacity to 100 beds. According to Dr. Barije, the outbreak of COVID-19 has so far claimed the lives of 114 people in the hospital. A total of 37 COVID patients are currently admitted at the hospital, with 24 severely ill. Barije said they have so far seen a total of 1,050 COVID patients since the outbreak of the pandemic. This story was compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news in Mbarara District.
Main camera, I'll be behind you.